Alright folks, and welcome back to the Don's channel. I am the Don Fella, and I'm now going to be doing a reaction video to the history, basically the origins of Australian rules football, and its creator. It's a documentary about Tom Wills, founder of Australian football, Aussie Rules. Credit for this video goes to Hallow Edition, so check out their channel guys and subscribe if you like them. I'm not going to spoil it by saying too much about it, but Tom Wills was actually a cricketer, and to keep fit, kind of invented Australian rules football. So hopefully the documentary will tell you a lot more than what I know about it, and I'll learn something and you'll learn something too. So no more talking, let's go! Melbourne. Long room. That is a long room. Look at the size of that table.
MCG Ray Weinberg interview, take one. Here is AOE.
Have you got any time to talk about TM Wills?
Tommy? I talk every two about Tommy Wills.
Yeah.
Thomas Wentworth Wills, and you ask most Australian football followers who Thomas Wentworth Wills was, and they haven't the faintest idea.
I know.
He was a young boy that came down from New South Wales with his parents. They took land in northwestern Victoria. His father's name was Horatio.
There's an old name.
In fact, his father named Mount Ararat. And in the days when he lived up there as a boy, there were a lot of Aboriginal tribes in the area. And Tom spent a lot of time playing with the Aboriginal children. And he spoke all the dialects of the tribes. So he was gifted. And there is unconfirmed stories that they played a game with the stuffed possum skin, which was a bit like kicking off. Now, I've spoken to our museum people here and our library people here, and that's sort of unconfirmed, but it's a nice story in any case. And so Tom played that, and when he was about 12 or 13, his father decided that home education had to be bolstered. So he sent him away to school, and you immediately think, oh, Melbourne or Sydney. He put him on a ship and took him to England, to the rugby school in England. And he stayed there for the rest of his school life and became captain of rugby and captain of cricket. And he was an outstanding cricketer. And at the conclusion of his school days, it was suggested that he should stay and play. A lot of the counties wanted him to play cricket because he was good. But he wanted to come home. And he got home in time to find that his father had taken a very big selection of land in Queensland, up around, I can never think of the place now, Springshaw. And that he, Tom, and his dad and 19 other people, his mother was remaining behind here, were heading to Queensland to set up a big sheep and cattle station. They went up to Rockhampton. And you've got to think of the times, this is mid-1800s. They picked 1,000 head of sheep, plus cattle, and took them 8 months to drive the stock out to the station site, because there were no roads or anything. And I think that in itself was a bit of an epic.
It really was.
Having got there, they built cattle yards and they were living under canvas. And Tom and a young shepherd went back down the track to pick up from and dump supplies of tea and rice and wheat and that they were running short of. Away for 2 days, they got back to the homestead site and every man, woman and child had been slaughtered by the Aborigines on the station, including his father. The only reason Tom and the shepherd survived is they weren't there. Now, he farmed on for another couple of years up there, came back to Melbourne, became secretary of the Melbourne Cricket Club. His name's on the honour board out there. And he was captain of Victoria, in cricket matches between Victoria and Tasmania in the...
New South Wales and Tasmania.
And then he decided there had to be a game that cricketers could play in the winter to keep fit. and made the declaration, we must have a game of our own, and was largely responsible for the establishment and the beginning of Australian rules football. And in fact, in our museum, the original handwritten rules of the game are down
there. Wow, that would be really good to see.
And recorded. And so he was the man who umpired that first game between the two schools. But the other remarkable thing about Wills is that in 1866, the first Aboriginal team, in fact, the first team that ever went from Australia to play cricket in England, was an all-Aboriginal team. And the coach of that team was Tom Wills. So never ever harboured any bad feelings towards the Aboriginal
team. Yeah, even though they killed his whole family and ourselves.
And sadly, over the following years, he fell out of favour and became an alcoholic and ultimately committed suicide.
Oh, what
a still
story.
A young man.
Wow.
It's an amazing story. I mean, I've just great
goosebumps then, man.
And it is an amazing story. And hopefully one day someone will make a documentary about it.
Yeah. Or even review it on the channel.
Yeah, there's two or three books been written about it. Yeah. It's a great character.
Well, thanks, Ray.
Okay.
Thanks for all that.
Pleasure.
There we go. 1858, so there you go. That's the first ever game there, right at the very end of the video. What a man he must have been. Greatly put together and greatly told there by that man in the documentary. Check it out in the museum if you've not done it. If you're in Australia and you're in Melbourne and you get a chance to go to the cricket ground, check out the handwritten rules. That sounds absolutely epic. If you love Australian rules and you want to see a bit of the history and come closer to it, but his story was absolutely sensational, wasn't it? When he got to school age, his father's like, home tutoring's not enough for you anymore. We're going to get you a proper education. His dad had an old name, Horatio. You don't hear many Horatios knocking about nowadays, I tell you. Sent him to England to a rugby school. He's ended up being captain of the rugby school, captain of the cricket, captain of the rugby team, captain of the cricket team. Exceptional cricketer. Came back to Australia, obviously worked on the farm. And that horrendous story of the Aboriginal tribe slaughtering his family and everybody else there that went to work on the ranch and farm with them. But he never held any grudges. Absolutely outstanding. The first cricket team he's took from Australia to England is an all-Aboriginal team that he's captained or managed. I can't remember what they said, if it was captain or managed there. But it just goes to show that the man himself, what a gentleman, what a man. And Aussie rules wouldn't be here without him. Maybe things that's happened in his life led to this, like getting sent to play rugby in England. Maybe he would never have been interested. Yes, he's played this game. I think it's called Narngrook or something like that there. It was played with a stuffed possum. It's like a hairy ball type thing. You can see pictures of it. Hopefully I'll get some more videos up about that later on. Obviously, nobody had actually done any research into it as such and made it official at the time this documentary's come out, so I presume there'll be something now that you can get sort of firm facts on that topic, and I will look into that as well. But I love to hear the roots and the origins of anything, and what a fantastic man he was. I actually got goosebumps watching that a little bit. An absolute gentleman, and so was the man telling the story there. The long hall or the long room or whatever it was, that table, epic table. Can you imagine the amount of drinks and meals that have been shared and funny stories that have been shared at that table over the years in that old cricket ground? Absolutely brilliant. And as I said, if you ever get the chance, if I get the chance, I certainly will do it. But for anyone in Melbourne, you're missing a trick here if you haven't went in there and looked at that to see the founding father of the sport that you love and that I love too. So thanks very much for tuning in. I hope you've learned a little bit if you didn't know that story already. I did. I already knew quite a bit about it, but not the dates, times, facts that he's went over to England and his family and stuff. But absolutely tremendous story. If anybody's got anything else you'd like to see me reacting to, please feel free to drop a comment in the section below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel, guys, and put the notifications bell on as well. You can also check out my Patreon's page, which is patreon.com/thedonschannel, and I'll put that link in the section below where you can become a patron and fund the channel and help the channel grow and bring it on the road to the wonderful land down under, the land of Oz, Australia. We plan on coming to Australia and doing vlogs in Australia and going to the footy grounds, and around the place and just seeing the sights, etc. And as I said, doing vlogs on the channel. Also, I'm doing a thing, sponsor my mullet. I'll grow a mullet if you sponsor me. If you don't sponsor me, I'm not growing the mullet because there's absolutely no way I'm cutting about with a mullet for it to get no sponsorship. The sponsorships, also like the Patreon page, will be going to fund the channel and grow the channel. So it's just a bit of fun. And the reason why I'm doing the mullet is because there's loads of AFL players right now sporting the old mullet. And I seem to be the one that's noticed it, and I've pointed it out. There's not a lot of people noticed it, but you will now. So anyway, thanks again for watching. I am the Donfall. That was a fantastic documentary, short documentary about Tom Wills, the founder of Australian Rules. Thanks very much. Goodbye, everyone, and I'll see you soon.